14 carats. I'm 14 carats. Hi guys, my name is Jasmine. Welcome back to my channel. So today I have this beautiful spring look for you guys. So spring is right around the corner. So I've been stalking Instagram for like beautiful, just bold, bright, springy looks. And I saw this beautiful look on Instagram. So this is the artist here on the original look. Her name is Katie. It looks so beautiful. So this is my version of the look. It's very similar, but I did do a couple things differently. So if you guys want to see how I got this look, then just keep watching. Alright guys, so we're going to get started with the Morphe 35B eyeshadow palette. I'm first taking the yellow shade and applying that all into my crease and partially on my lid area. Next, I'm gonna take the orange shade in this palette and blend that into the yellow, keeping this more in my crease and on the top portion of my eyelid. I'm just blending these two colors out so they blend really nice and seamlessly. And next, I'm gonna take the bright pink shade from the palette and I'm going to pack this on into my outer V portion of my lid and as well as in my crease area. And I'm gonna blend this shade in with the orange really nicely. So I'm gonna take the same brush I used for the orange to blend out the pink shade. I'm gonna keep packing on the pink so the color is very opaque and bright, because these colors do kind of get a little more sheer as you keep blending. So you just want to keep going back in and packing on the color so you keep the same amount of pigment that you want. So I'm just going to blend these out really nicely so they look very smooth and create a beautiful ombre effect, which they're already doing. I'm just adding in more color where I feel like it's missing color on my lids and going back and blending that out once again. So now I'm going to be doing the cut crease. I'm using concealer and a big flat brush from MAC to create this cut crease. If you work really slowly, it's a lot easier to control your hand. So just work really slowly when you're doing this carving out portion for your eyes. I like to carve out right a little bit above my eyelid. My eyes are slightly hooded. They're not hooded eyes, but they're like slightly hooded. I have a little bit of a I guess a medium-sized eyelid, I guess. And so I like to go a little bit above that. So when my eyes are open, you can still see whatever I have on my lid. So I'm going to just blend the pink shade into the concealer to help it transition better. And next, I'm going to take the yellow shade and apply that in the inner portion of my eyelid. This is the bright yellow from the palette. And I'm just blending that in with the a pencil brush. Next, I'm going to take the orange shade and do the same exact thing with another pencil brush. I'm going to apply the orange to the center of my eyelid, blending the orange out into the yellow and the bright pink color. Once everything is nice and blended, I'm going to take this glitter from Urban Decay. It is one of their glitter liquid things. I forget what they're called. And I'm going to be using a pink shade to apply that in the cut crease area, with the area where I carved out my cut crease. And it's going to add some definition and also some sparkle to the look, which I like. So we're going to do that. And once we're done with that, we're going to apply mascara and then on to the face makeup. I'm using the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the color Walnut, and I love it. I'm going to blend that out using a beauty blender, but I'm also going to be contouring with the Fenty Beauty Matchstick in Espresso and blend that out with a Makeup Geek blending or stippling brush. So once I do that, I'm going to bake under my eyes. For my baking powder, I'm going to be using the Too Faced Born This Way powder. And then I'm going to move on to my lower lash line. I'm doing the same exact steps in reverse. Well, not really, I guess. But I'm going to use the yellow shade first, and then I'm going to go in with the orange shade. And then lastly, I'm going to take the pink shade and apply all those colors on my lower lash line. The pink shade goes really, really tight in my waterline. The yellow is more so on the outer portion, and the orange shade is more in the middle of my lower lash line. And doing this really just pulls the look together. It doesn't make it top heavy where your top lid is full of color and your bottom lid is like bare. So I just like doing that to pull the look together. So basically just keep blending out those three colors on your bottom lash line using pencil brushes and tiny blending brushes. Once you get your desired look, you can keep going with your face makeup. I'm going to be bronzing using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Bronze in Mahogany, and I'm using a Sigma blush brush to bronze my face. I just like the shape of this brush for bronzing. I like to bronze the top of my nose a little bit, And for my highlight, I'm using the Huda Beauty 3D palette in Bronze Sands, which I have been loving. I'm using it to highlight everything on my face, my nose, my cheekbones, my upper lip, and my inner corner to help give this look a nice pop. Like, hello, I'm here. For my lips, I'm going to line them first with Max Lip Liner in Espresso. And I'm going to take this bright orange color from NYX. Oh, sorry, this is ColourPop, the Luxe Lipsticks. And then this NYX color in the center. This is a Hollywood Lashes from Lily Lash. And that is the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys in my next video.